हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम वीना शर्मा, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर बॉटनी, एसपीसी गवर्नमेंट कॉलेज अजमेर. टुडे वी विल डिस्कस समथिंग अबाउट कम्युनिटी इकोलॉजी एंड इट्स कैरेक्टरिस्टिक फीचर्स. एज वी ऑल नो, द प्लांट्स दे डू नॉट ग्रो इन आइसोलेशन इन नेचर. In most habitats, the members of a species, they grow mingled with the members of many other species. And such groups, and the species mixture or the assemblies, they are called communities or associations. Actually, the community is assemblies of plants, animals and microorganisms. They all live together and they utilize the resources of the nature. But today we will discuss more specifically about only plant communities. As we all know, when we classify ecology on the basis of levels of organization, then community is a level of organization. Means what is the level of organization? Means at what level we are studying ecology or the interrelationships between organism and the environment. As you all know, what is ecology? It is the interrelationship of organism and the environment. These interrelationships we study at different levels. The lowest level in this study is the organism. Okay, the other branches of botany, they deals just below the organism, means like cytology and physiology and biochemistry and genetics. They are the levels below organism level. In ecology, we consider organism as a whole at the lowest, as the lowest level. The study of interrelationship of any organism to the environment is the study area of aut ecology, or we call it aut ecology. If we increase our level of study, means above the level of organism, we deals with the organisms of similar types. Similar types means species. And the group of similar type of species is known as population in ecology. So the population becomes another level of organization. And different populations, if they grow together in association, in groups, then this level becomes community. Means community is, we can say community is a set of organisms coexisting within a defined area. It is a group of population living in a unit area. And community ecology is the study of these coexisting populations or interdependent populations which grow in association in an unit area, in a defined area, and they are interrelated with each other. So it is the study of interaction between these organisms and the interactions between the organisms and their environment. And above this community level, there are other levels also, like ecosystem and biome. Ecosystem ecology and biome ecology, we call them. Now these communities or these mixture or group of species, they occur in different combinations. The communities, they change with the change in the environment. Means as the environment changes in an area, the type of community also changes. Means communities are dynamic. We can say communities are dynamic. So we can define community as a naturally occurring, mutually sustaining and interacting assemblage or group of plants and animals living in the same environment and utilizing and transferring energy in some manner. In this definition, community has all organisms, including plants, animals, and microorganisms of a given area. The plant community is we can define as the group of plants having different species. The plants can be taxonomically different, but they are at the same level ecologically. Means they are interrelated with each other, they are interdependent and self-sufficient. Here we can say that the concept of community is not new, it's very old. The father of botany, as you all know, who was father of botany, was Theophrastus. He also points out about communities, or at his time the study of plants was based on the formations or the group of plants or the community level, we can say community level. In ancient times, the food producing plants, the timber yielding plants, but they are taxonomically different. They were taxonomically different. They were found in some area, and the studies were like this. The study of these particular type of utility plants, we can say useful plants. Carl Mobius was the scientist who introduced the term biotic community or the bio community, because as we all know, plants and animals, they live together and their independent existence is not possible. So here we can point out some more names of scientists who were engaged in the study of plant communities in different regions of the world. Like in USA, the names of scientists or the community ecologists, they were Coles and Clements. They emphasized on process of succession. In Britain, Tansley was the main community ecologist who emphasized the idea of succession in community classification. In North Europe, the scientists were Hult and Duritz. In Europe, some more scientists were there who were engaged in phytosociological studies, like Ronquier. In Southern Europe, the phytosociological or the physiognomic studies of the community was done by Brown Blanket. So in today's world, they are also considered as the best phytosociologist. In addition to above, there with a different viewpoint, not very clear, they developed also a Russian school of thought. So in different studies regarding community ecology, they led to the development of 5 lines of traditional thoughts of community studies. Kendrick 1974, he divided the biotic community into 2 types, major communities and minor communities. Major communities are large self-sustaining and independent units like coral reefs, rocky mountains, forests, mangroves, like this. And minor communities are smaller, not very self-sustaining, and they are dependent on other communities for growth, like oysters, algae, and like this. Communities can be open or closed community. Means if there are number of plants are less and there is a space for more plants to come in the area, then these communities are open communities. And if the species diversity is very high, the number of plants are too high, then these, and they are self-sustaining, then they don't allow other plants to come in that area, and this becomes a closed community. There are certain characteristic features on the basis of any community is designated. One of them is species diversity. Species diversity means each community is made up of much different organisms like plants, animals, microbes, and they differ taxonomically from each other. Means variety of organisms live in any plant community. The number of species and population in community also vary. The diversity is at 2 levels. One is regional diversity, means the diversity of whole nation or the part of continent in which different communities exist. And the other diversity is local diversity. Local diversity means at local level, like even a nation or a state where different communities, they exist in different areas. Second characteristic feature of any community is growth form and structure. Growth and structure. Community is described in terms of growth forms. Growth forms are the general appearance of the plant, like they are trees and shrubs and mosses on the basis of their height, how they look like. And in each growth forms, as in trees, there may be different kind of plants, as broad-leaved, evergreen trees, like this. These different forms, they determine actually the structural pattern of a community. On the basis of different growth forms, structure of community is decided, means how they are vertically stratified or they are horizontally stratified. We will study it in our later classes. The third characteristic feature of any community is the dominance. In each community, all the species are not equally important. Only few of these plants, which they are dominant plants of that community, and they determine the nature of the community. These species, they actually exert major controlling factor, major controlling influence on the community, and these are known as dominants. And the communities are known by their name, like sal forest or shisham forest, like this, teak forest. Then the next is succession. सक्सेशन इज़ अगेन एन अनदर इम्पॉर्टेंट कैरेक्टरिस्टिक फीचर ऑफ एनी कम्युनिटी एंड सक्सेशन इज़ वेरी इम्पॉर्टेंट इन डेवलपमेंट ऑफ द कम्युनिटी. हाउ द कम्युनिटी इज़ डेवलप्ड इट इज़ डिसाइडेड बाई द पैटर्न्स ऑफ सक्सेशन और द कम्युनिटी सम चेंजेस दे अकर इन कम्युनिटी एंड द अनदर टाइप ऑफ कम्युनिटी इज़ डेवलप्ड ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ दीज चेंजेस एंड दीज directional changes which occur in any community is they decide the successional pattern or any community has the successional pattern or the succession on which the community is formed or developed. So succession is another important character. Now the next characteristic feature is trophic level. Trophic level means different type of on the basis of nutrition different type of levels are found in a community. Means some organisms they are producers and the other ones are consumers and decomposers. Producers are green plants in any community. The food produced by the green plant is transferred to consumers or the consumers consume it directly or indirectly. And the different trophic levels are present in the community. Some are autotrophs, some are heterotrophs. They exist as self-sufficient and perfectly balanced assemblies of the organism. So, in this type, these are the specific characteristic features of any community which decide the nature of the community, and these characteristics are the features of any community, not the species which form that community. These characteristic features, they are taken as a characteristic features of the whole community. Means individual community is not studied in individual form, it is studied in the group as a group characters. Now community, we will study the composition of the community, and in composition we will see how community is composed. Means how community may be large or small. Larger communities, they extend over areas of several thousands of square kilometers, and smaller communities, they may be of very small size, like communities or micro habitats or microorganisms on leaf surface, the water drop, even a water drop on a plate, it can be considered as a small community. So size of the community, it may vary from very small size to very large sized communities. And these community, the number of species and the population abundance in the communities, they vary greatly. In each community there are diverse species, and as we know, we have studied in characteristic of community, these species are not equally important, but these are only few overtopping species which by their bulk and growth they modify the habitat. They are known as dominants. Means if we remove these dominants from the community, the structure of the community will alter. They form a sort of characteristic nucleus in the community. So the communities are known by the names of these dominant species, like I tell you spruce forest or the teak forest or like this. So sometimes one species is dominant in a community, then it is known as consociation, and sometimes more than one species may be dominant in any area, then this type of community is known as association. Example is like oak hickory forest, means oak and hickory, these two plants, they dominate the community. Okay, now we will see the structure of the community. In structure of the community, we will discuss about the stratification or the zonation. In the field of ecology, it refers to the vertical layering of a habitat. By structure, we mean the arrangement of the communities, arrangement of the plants in a community. Structure or the zonation or the stratification, we call it as stratification. They are of two types: vertical stratification and horizontal stratification. Vertical stratification, it refers to vertical distribution of organism in a country, community. Means in a forest community, or for example in a forest community, there are five types of zonation. These zonation in the vegetation, zonation means strata or stratification in forest community, is on the basis of light resource. The plants live in this community, and they acquire different growth forms on the basis of requirement of light. Some plants, they are found just near the ground, and some are in the emergent layer or the canopy layer. So these five vertical strata, they are found in forest forest community, like subterranean strata, means the lowermost strata, basal portion covered by litter and debris of the plant as well as animals. Second layer is forest floor, this abundance of litter, and this region is the zone of decomposition, and some small plants are also found here. Third, above this forest floor is the stratum of herbaceous vegetation. It is formed by herbaceous plants like grasses, dicotyledons, annuals, like this. They are found here. Then fourth is the substratum of shrubs. Here you can see in this diagram, the subterranean region, then forest floor, then herbaceous, then shrub layer, and it is the fourth layer. It is located below the crown layer and above the herbaceous layer, and they are represented by shrubby life forms. And lastly, above on top of all these, stratum of tree or the topmost layer, and it is also called the crown layer, which represents highest limit of plant community in a region. So this is the structure of community, means one type of structure, that is vertical stratification or vertical structure of a community. In similar way, this vertical stratification, it is found at one place in the community, and in another type of structure or stratification, which is horizontal stratification, we move on latitudes, we move on the ground, and we find different type of communities when we move from one place to another, on like from equator to polar region, or from foothills to the top of the mountains on high altitudes. If we go on high altitudes, we find different type of communities. On foothills, there are grasslands, or the forest are there, the tropical vegetation is there. If we go on some height, the plants are found, different type of plants are found, like deciduous forest are found. And if we go on another high altitudes, then the coniferous plants are found, and on top of the mountains we found alpine vegetation, which are snow covered mountain peaks, and these lichens and some type of vegetation is there. So if we move from lower level to higher level on mountain, on high altitudes, we find different type of vegetation on high altitudes and on high latitudes also. The similar type of vegetation type is found in these two directions. So this is known as horizontal stratification, and this is about structure of the plant community. Thank you very much. We will continue it in next